I want to talk to you about theology for a few minutes. So this is a word that has ordinarily been defined in this way. When we say, what is theology? People have often said that theology is the study of God. Well, I think we can do a bit better than that. Some of the greatest theologians have said something that's a bit more specific and more interesting and really more profound. So some people have defined theology this way, that theology is the teaching of living for God. That's actually one of the books that I'm reading right now with our youth leaders is this, Living for God by Mark Jones. And Jones quotes Peter van Maastricht, who's one of the great theologians from the 17th century, and van Maastricht defined theology this way. He said, theology is most correctly defined as the doctrine of living for God through Christ. The interesting thing here is van Maastricht, his magnum opus, his greatest work of theology is called A Theoretical Practical Theology. So he understood that we can keep the theory of theology must lead to righteous living or the practical, living it out. So I think that is a superior definition of theology, that theology is not some abstract study disconnected from life, but no, theology is actually the teaching of living for God. So if you ask now, what is living for God? And yeah, I think we can make another contribution by exploring the topic of love. So in the Bible, Jesus and Moses and the apostles, they made it clear that loving God and loving your neighbor fulfills the law. For instance, in Galatians 5:14, Paul says, the whole law is fulfilled in one word, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. So if you love God and you love your neighbor, this is what it means to live for God. And that would mean that you are being a good theologian if you love God and you love your neighbor. I want to quote you from 1 Corinthians 13 verse 2. Here Paul brings in this idea of knowledge and love, and he says that love is, if you don't have love, then all the knowledge you have is ultimately in vain and false. So Paul says, if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. So clearly we can see here that in order to be a good theologian, you have to live for God. And what it means to live for God is to love your neighbor and the Lord. J.I. Packer also said this. He said, theology is for doxology. So we do theology in order to praise God, in order to worship God, in order to have this, a loving, knowing relationship with the Lord. So if we find someone that happens to be a professing Christian, but this person is living a sinful lifestyle, a hypocritical lifestyle, then it shows you that they are not actually a good theologian, because it means that they haven't had enough theology. So if someone's living a hypocritical, sinful lifestyle and while saying they are a Christian, it's not because they know too much theology. It's simply that they haven't done good theology. They don't know enough theology. They need a more accurate, truer, more vibrant, biblical theology, which would tell them that they need to live out the truth. And if they are not doing that, then they are actually a bad theologian. So it's very easy for us to criticize others and to look down upon them. We who see ourselves as orthodox and conservative, it's very easy for us to think of other people and say, oh, this person, they're not as good as me, and to be judgmental and critical of them. I'll use an example. For instance, I'm a Calvinist, so I hold to the doctrines of grace. And Calvinists often will feel superior to Arminians and will say, oh, you know, these poor Arminians, they don't know what they're talking about. They don't have an inkling about what the Bible teaches. And so they will have this critical spirit about them. But that's really bad, because if that brother or sister who's an Arminian, if they are more loving than you, then actually, evidently, they are also a better theologian than you. So the key is to keep love and truth together. We cannot separate orthodoxy from orthopraxy. The right teaching must lead to right living. So finally, let me just say that both your head and your heart and your hands matter to the Lord.